Hi guys, it's Molly. Welcome back to my channel. It is officially April 30th, which means it is the end of the month. So I figured that I was going to do the end of month wrap up of every book that I read. And I read a lot this month thanks to quarantine. This month I was able to read 12 books, and that's insane because I definitely do not ever read that much every month because usually I'm working and I don't have time to read. But I had time, so I read. So I'm just gonna go in the order on book reads that I read the books and tell you a little bit about them and what I rated them. So the first book that I read this month is The Two Lies of Lydia Byrd by Josie Silver, and I rated this book 3 stars, and it was eh. The story follows Lydia, obviously, who just recently has become widowed because her husband died in a car accident, and it follows her where she basically gets these pills from her doctor, which when she goes to sleep, she is basically living life with her husband. I forget the husband's name. What was his name? Freddie. And she basically lives this life with him where he never died. And then she's also dealing with the real world where she's not dreaming and not with him. And there wasn't really anything until like the second part of the story, because this is told in 3 parts. And the first part is just entirely her grieving. It was alright. Honestly, just the story was meh. I felt like it was really long for what it should have been. It looks like on Goodreads it's got a 4-star rating, which I guess is alright. I gave it 3 stars, and it wasn't all that interesting to me. The next book that I read this month was Lola and the Boy Next Door by Stephanie Perkins, and this is the second book in the Anne and the French Kiss like trilogy. And I've had this book and I had the third book, and I just never got around to reading them after I read the first one. I really loved Anne and the French Kiss, and I was like, I should just finish up this series. So I picked up Lola and the Boy Next Door. What did I rate this? I rated it 5 stars. How did I not remember that I rated it 5 stars? Anyway, this follows Lola and the boy next door, Cricket, and Cricket's family has moved away, and they move back next door to her, and it follows her and Cricket's story, and Cricket's sister, I can't remember Cricket's sister, Calliope? She had a weird name. I think her name was Calliope. And Calliope hates Lola with a passion, and it just follows their story of how they rekindled their friendship because they used to have a really good friendship, and then he moved away, and it was very sketchy like leading up to when his family moved away. So they end up rekindling their friendship, and it's just a cute story, very YA, just adorable. So I rated it 5 stars. And since I decided I was going to finish that trilogy, I end up reading Isla and the Happily Ever After by Stephanie Perkins. I believe I rated this 5 stars as well. Oh, I rated this 4 stars. And this is the ending of the trilogy. Isla and Josh develop their relationship in Manhattan in the summer before they go back to school in France. And so they become boyfriend and girlfriend, they go back to the school in France, and they're dealt with a lot of trouble. Josh just gets himself in trouble in school a lot, and his family drama. He is, I think, the senator's son, or he's a son to like someone who's like big in Manhattan. So their relationship just kind of crumbles, and then they decide to end things, but then, you know, typical YA, they find each other again. And yeah, so I rated it 4 stars. It was all right. I liked how in the end it tied like all the characters together from the previous books, which was really cute. And honestly, I kind of wish this wasn't the last book. I wish that Stephanie would continue, because there is a character in 2 of the books. Her name is Meredith, and I really wish we could get her story, because she actually is like in love with St. Clair from the first story. And then obviously she doesn't end up with him because he ends up with Anna, but she is mentioned in this book as well, kind of just like dealing with the fact that she's not with him. And I don't know, I think it'd be cute to like see her story of unrequited love, because that's the story of my life. Now getting out of the YA light reads, I read Credence by Penelope Douglas, and this was a wild ride, and I enjoyed the shit out of this book. So I rated this 5 stars, And it follows Tiernan, who just recently has become orphaned because her parents kill themselves together and leave her. And her step uncle, I forget his name, what was the step uncle? Jake. Her step uncle Jake gets in contact with her and is pretty much like, she's like a few months shy of turning 18. So he's pretty much like, I'm like your legal adult. So if you want to come live with me, you can. Plus they never met each other. So she just kind of like takes it upon herself to decide that she's going to go and live with them. And he has two sons. There is Caleb and what is the other kid's name? Noah. Caleb and Noah. And she develops a relationship with all three of them. And it's a wild ride. I do have some thoughts about this book. So if anybody would want like a review on this or something about my thoughts, I definitely wouldn't mind doing that because there's some things I'd like to discuss, but I don't want to spoil this book in case you haven't read it yet and you want to read it. It is a little thick. It's 470 pages, but oh my god, I could not put this down when I read it. It was 5 stars for me. I loved the crap out of this. And it was my first story where like it's a group of people. I know that has a term, but I can't think of it right now. But a group of people that are like together, and I don't know, man. It was a good ass story. And if you're thinking of reading this, I definitely would recommend, because Penelope Douglas is really good with steam, and it was chef's kiss. Very good. I also read another Penelope Douglas book this month, which is Punk 57, because Chandler Ainslie said this is one of her favorite books, and I was like, I really want to read it. I picked it up and I rated this 5 stars. This story follows Misha and Ryan, who when they're in grade school are paired together because their teachers think that they are the same gender. They think that Misha and Ryan are both boys, but Ryan's actually a girl and Misha is a boy. And anyway, they stay in contact all throughout their childhood until they're in high school, and then something happens to Misha and he just stops responding to Ryan altogether. And then he actually ends up going to or transferring to Ryan's school, but they've never met each other, so she has no idea that it's him, but he knows it's her because something happens that he finds out who she is. And it's just a really good book. It's a little shorter than Credence. This is 325 pages, but it was really, really good. I really like Penelope Douglas's stories. Right now I'm reading Misconduct because that is like the only one that I haven't read besides like her series, like her Bully series I haven't read, and the Corrupt series I haven't read yet, but I am going to read them. But her other standalone, Misconduct, I am currently reading and I am enjoying so far. But if you have never read Penelope Douglas, you have to. Her steam is amazing. Like, the steamy scenes are so good and steamy, and I really like them. So definitely recommend this book. The next book I read this month was The Bride Test by Helen Huang. This is the second story in the Kiss Quotient series, and there is going to be a third book that follows Kwon, and I'm so excited to read that. But this story follows, what are their names? Kai and Esme. And Kai has, I believe it's Asperger's, and he just believes that he can never love somebody. So his mom takes it upon herself to find him a mail order bride, which is Esme, and basically tells her that she has the summer to make him fall in love with her. And if she can't do that, then she can just go back home to her life. Such a cute story. It shows Kai's like character development so well. Helen Huang writes really good romance, and it was just so cute. And I loved it. And I can't wait for Kwon's book, because Kwon is a character that's in both of these stories, because in this story, he's Kai's brother. And then in the first story, he's Michael's cousin, I believe. And he's just an amazing character, so I can't wait to read his story. I'm not sure if that's going to be the final book in this series, but it was a really good book, and I think I rated this 5 stars. Yes, I rated it 5 stars, so definitely recommend this book. Next, I read Pregnant at 17 by Christine Conrad. I rated this 3 stars, and it was all right. It's a short little story. I wanted to branch out from romance because I do typically read just romance, so I picked this book up on Book Outlet. You'd think that Pregnant at 17 it sounds like it'd be a romance, but it really wasn't. So the story follows Chelsea, and she has a relationship with, I don't remember his name, but he is a married man, and she knows that he's married, but he told her that he's gonna be getting a divorce because his wife was cheating on him first, pretty much. And so they have a relationship, and she finds out she's pregnant with his son, or I think it's a girl. Anyway, she finds out she's pregnant with his baby, and she tells him, and he goes ballistic, saying, like, he can't be in a relationship with her, he can't have this child. He pretty much, like, offers her $10,000 to just get an abortion and forget about him, and Chelsea doesn't do that. And then there's also this little plot in this that kind of made it, like, thrillery, where there's this guy who went to prison, and Chelsea is terrified of him, and he kind of like comes after her, and it was just kind of like a little bit of a wild ride. I honestly don't really know, like, I think the story could have done without that aspect, because it just, I don't think it needed to be all that. But I rated it 3 stars. It was all right. There are 2 other books in her At 17 series. There's Missing at 17 and Murdered at 17. I do have both of those, but I haven't read them yet. But yeah, I don't know if I would recommend this. I mean, if you want like a little easy read, because the font is kind of large, so you can get through this really easily. I read this in a day, so it was alright. The next story I read this month was not a physical book, but it was a digital ARC that I was sent from NetGalley, and that was The Anti-Virginity Pact by Kate Wismer. And this story I rated 2 stars. I did not like the story at all. You can read my Goodreads review if you want my Goodreads account. I just did not like this story. I went in with very high expectations, thinking that this was going to be a really good story about a girl, you know, like losing her virginity and everything that like leads up to it. But that was not it. That was not the case. I was very disappointed in this story. I think it was my lowest rated book that I read this month, and it wasn't it. And I felt bad because it is a booktuber author. Like, Kate is a booktuber, and she like vlogged pretty much writing the story, but I just did not like it at all. I was very disappointed, and there were some like weird aspects in the story that just threw me for a loop, and I just did not like it, so we're just gonna move on. The next book that I read this month was also a digital ARC that I was sent from NetGalley, and that is Drive by Courtney McGuire. I rated this 3 stars. It was my first male-male romance book, and it was weird. There's like a weird like animal roleplay kink in here, which I was not expecting at all. The character development was really nice, but that was just like threw me for a loop because I was not expecting that at all. And there was, I just wanted more from the story. Like, our main character, Red, he has a relationship with this guy, and then there's this other guy who he has like a friend relationship with but turns romantic, and I really wanted more of that relationship rather than the one that we get where he is romantic with, because that one just, it was weird. I rated it 3 stars. It was all right. I think if you want to like dive into kind of more taboo stories where like there was the animal kink, I guess I would recommend that, but it was very weird and definitely an experience. Next, I read Beach Read by Emily Henry, and this was another story that kind of just disappointed me. I rated this 3 stars. I had very high expectations for the story, but I was sadly let down. It follows 2 authors. What are their names? I am so bad at remembering the names. Augustus and January. And Augustus writes literary fiction, January writes romance, and they're staying in 2 lakeside beach houses for the summer, and they decided they're gonna swap genres and write each other's books, and they make a pact, like, if whoever like writes theirs first gets to publish it, and basically just shove it in each other's face. And there's this weird aspect where like Augustus takes her to do research with him, and they're like interviewing cult members who like siblings died because of suicide, and that was just really weird and like the tone of this book just was like all over the place, I felt. And then there's the aspect of like her father dying, which is why she is staying in this house, and she finds out like her father like actually like was cheating on her mother, and I don't know, it was just very weird. Not what I expected. I was expecting this to be like a lighthearted like beach read that like was just gonna be like one of those happy romances, and it just wasn't it. There was like humor in here that I liked, and there were some scenes that I liked, but I couldn't get past the weirdness of like the research that her and Augustus do that just didn't flow with the story. So I gave this 3 stars. I was kind of disappointed that it couldn't read it anymore, but what can you do? The next book I read this month was On the Island by Tracy Garbus Graves. I rated this 5 stars. This was such a good book. It's an age gap taboo kind of romance about, what are their names? I'm not gonna remember names. Anna and TJ. Anna is TJ's tutor, and she and him are traveling to the Maldives because his parents paid her to tutor him for the summer because he has just recently battled cancer and missed a lot of school because of that. So she takes on the job to tutor him in the summer, and on their plane ride there, the plane crashes and they're on a deserted island, and they're there for a few years, and they develop a relationship when he is of age. When they get there, I think he's 16 or 17, and they leave when he's 19, I believe, but they don't start any relationship until he is of age. But the taboo-ness is that, like, she's his teacher, and the story was so cute. The character development was very, very good, and I really like this book. And there is a little novella that I'm gonna pick up, I think, on Kindle Unlimited. I think it's on Kindle Unlimited. If not, I'm gonna pay for it. But I love this book so much. It was so good, and I'm very happy that I read this. I think Gabby Reads is the one who I got this recommendation from, so thank you, Gabby. And yeah, I really enjoyed this book, and I was so happy when I found it on Book Outlet for really cheap. So if you're looking for a new like taboo age gap romance, this is the one you should pick up. And the last physical book that I read this month is Bird Box by Josh Malerman. I rated this 3 stars, and that is because I honestly did not know that Bird Box was a book before it was a movie, so I had watched the movie before reading the book, and I like the book more than the movie. And I know that there are some people who are probably like really mad at me right now that I like the book more, or the movie more than the book, but there were just some things in the story that I just did not like. Did I write a review? I did not write a review, but I should have, because I just didn't really enjoy the book that much. There was one scene in particular that kind of had me like, ooh, like what's gonna happen, I'm not gonna spoil it for you, but there is one scene that I was kind of like, what's gonna happen, there's the birthing scene in this book that literally just made me feel disgusting, and I did not want to like keep reading, but obviously I had to because I was trying to finish this book. Ugh, that was so grotesque and just disgusting. So I definitely liked the movie a lot better than the book. Also the character, Gary, I liked him better in the movie than I did in the book, which some people might not like, but I don't know. I just rated this 3 stars, and yeah, that's all I got for you guys. The next book I read was a novella. It's called There's for the Night by Katie Roper. That was part of the book optional for the Smutathon that I totally failed at because, of course, I need to do things. That's a whole other story, but I ended up rating that 3 stars. I thought it was okay. The steaminess really wasn't that great in my opinion, but it isn't the novella, like the prequel for the full series, which I don't remember what the full series is called. I just did not really enjoy the novella that much, so I rated it 3 stars, and that's it. And the last book that I read this month, I actually literally just finished today, was another ARC that I was sent by NetGalley, and that is The Apartment by K.L. Slater. This book I rated 3.5 stars. It definitely was a wild ride. There was a plot twist that I was not expecting, which, wow, was really crazy. The reason I rated it 3.5 stars, though, was because I felt like some things could have been taken out and the story would have been fine, and maybe there could have been a little more that K.L. Slater could have added to the story. Overall, I thought it was a good book. I definitely would read more K.L. Slater because I did enjoy this book, but there were just some aspects that I thought could have been better. But overall, it was pretty good. I would definitely recommend it. And that's everything that I read this month. Oh my goodness. And all my books are starting to fall. I live in New York State and we are on pause until May 15th. Could possibly be longer, I don't know. So I do have a few weeks of reading that I can do. I'm very excited, although I have been playing a lot of Animal Crossing, which has kind of been hard to balance Animal Crossing and reading. But I'm trying to find the happy medium so that I can do both. I hope you guys enjoyed though. I'll have all my links in the description, my Bookstagram, my Goodreads, all that good stuff, so you guys can follow me on any of that if you are interested. Let me know if you read any books that I read this month, or if you didn't read them this month but you have read them, if you enjoyed them and what you rated them, and I will see you guys in the next video. Bye guys!